अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मैं हूँ इश्फाक रियाज डार और आज हमने एक और फिजिक्स का टॉपिक, इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक आपके लिए चुना है। जी हाँ, मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ द वेक्टर्स। एंड यू ऑलरेडी नो फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द वेक्टर्स, दे पजेस बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड एज वेल एज डायरेक्शन, सो दे डोंट फॉलो द ऑर्डिनरी लॉज ऑफ द अलजेब्रा। सो टू मल्टीप्लाई देम वी यूज टू स्पेशल ऑपरेशंस, वन द डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द वेक्टर्स एंड अनदर द क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द वेक्टर्स। एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ वेक्टर्स एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस cross product of vectors. So our topic will be today cross product of vectors. Cross product of vectors. So if I have two vectors A and B inclined at an angle theta. So this is vector A, vector B, and the angle between them is theta. Now how to define the cross product? This is A cross B. Basically, cross product is also called the vector product of the vectors. Why? Because we always get a vector quantity after multiplying, after having a cross product of the two vectors. So, A cross B, it is basically a third vector C, whose magnitude is equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B, and sine of the smaller angle between the two vectors. So this is AB sine theta, product of the magnitudes of the two vectors and sine of the smaller angle between the two. Since cross product gives a vector quantity, so this should have some direction as well. And that direction is given by NK, where NK is the unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. Here, perpendicular to the plane of paper. So it is perpendicular to A and B. And the direction of this very plane, since I can draw two perpendiculars to this very plane, one pointing upwards and another pointing downwards. So, to give the direction of this very NK, that is A cross B, we have two rules. Number one, right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. Or right hand corkscrew rule. Right hand corkscrew rule to give the direction of this A cross B. Now what does this right hand thumb rule state? Simply, now this is our right hand. If you curl your fingers in the direction of A cross B, then this erected thumb, it will give you the direction of this N cap, that is, it will give you the direction of A cross B. So, the statement of this right hand thumb rule is that if you hold your right hand palm on a board, on a plane of paper or plane of board, in such a way that the curled fingers, that you curl the fingers in the direction of A cross B. Here you are curling the fingers in anti-clockwise direction, so the thumb is pointing towards you. So the A cross B, it will be perpendicular to the plane of board and vertically upwards. So this will give me the direction of A cross B as per right hand thumb rule. Simply, if you move from A to B in anti-clockwise direction, then the direction of A cross B is perpendicular to the plane containing A and B and vertically upwards. And if you curl your right hand, if you curl the fingers of your right hand in such a way that you move from A to B in clockwise direction, then again thumb will give you the direction of the A cross B, but right now it will point in vertically downward direction. So if you move in clockwise direction from A to B, then the thumb will point again perpendicular to the plane of board, but right now inwards. So this is outwards and this is inwards. Or we can also give the direction of A cross B by right hand corkscrew rule. Simply, let this be a right handed corkscrew, and if you rotate the handle of this very screw in clockwise direction, if you rotate it in clockwise direction, see, it will go, the screw will go inwards. The screw, the rotating screw will give you the direction of A cross B. And if you rotate it in anti-clockwise, if you move from A to B in anti-clockwise direction, then the screw will point upwards. So once again, the direction of this A cross B, it will be perpendicular to the plane and vertically inwards when you move clockwise. And when you move anti-clockwise, the direction of this n cap is again perpendicular to the plane of paper, plane of board, and vertically upward. So this was all about the direction of this A cross B given by right-handed screw rule or right-hand thumb rule. Now let us try to interpret this A cross B geometrically. I mean, what does this A cross B mean from geometrical point of view? Now let me write here geometrical interpretation of A cross B, that is cross product of two vectors. Geometrical interpretation. For that, let me consider two vectors, again A and B, inclined at an angle theta. Suppose this is vector A, this is vector B, inclined at an angle theta. Let me complete the parallelogram. For example, this is P, Q, or and S. This PQ will represent the magnitude of A, PS will represent the magnitude of B. And to calculate the area of the parallelogram, let me draw SN perpendicular to PQ. So let me calculate the magnitude of A cross B. The magnitude of A cross B, as per its definition, it will be given by A B sine of theta. Right? Okay. Now let me calculate here area of parallelogram. This is area of parallelogram P, Q, or S. As per its formula, this is given by simply PQ base into height into SN. Right? Now this is a right-angled triangle PNS. So in a right-angled triangle PNS, let me calculate sine of theta. Sine theta, that is perpendicular by hypotenuse, that is SN divided by PS. So from this, SN is equal PS sine theta. Now this is SN, that is equal to PS sine theta. Let me substitute it here, so I will get area of parallelogram P, Q, or S, that is given by PQ into SN. Or SN ke badle mein kya likhunga? PS sine theta. So this is PS sine of theta. Now PQ, so this will be equal to magnitude of A. Okay, what about this PS? Magnitude of B and sine theta. So this is AB sine theta, which you already remember. It is the magnitude of A cross B. So geometrically, magnitude of A cross B represents the area of parallelogram, here PQ or S, whose two adjacent sides are given by two vectors A and B, here PQ and BS. So geometrically it represents the area of parallelogram. Now let me join SQ here, that is the diagonal of a parallelogram. Aapko ek theorem yaad hai, the diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two triangles, rather two congruent triangles of equal area. Kyun? Main aapko bataunga by SSS congruency criteria. So here you can see area of triangle PQS, it will be equal to area of triangle QRS. So I can also write area of parallelogram PQRS, it will be equal to area of this triangle plus area of this triangle. Simply I can write it twice area of triangle PQS. So we can also interpret the magnitude of A cross B, that is magnitude of cross product of two vectors, either it is equal to area of parallelogram PQ or S here, or it is equal to twice the area of triangle PQS. So geometrically, the magnitude of cross product basically represents The area of parallelogram whose two adjacent sides are given by two vectors, rather two given vectors A and B, or it is also equal twice the area of triangle whose two sides are represented by two vectors. This was all about the geometrical interpretation of cross product. Now let us discuss few properties of the cross product. So let me write here properties of cross product of vectors. Properties of cross product of vectors. Now, first property is you can easily interpret it here. Suppose this is vector A, this is vector B, inclined at an angle theta. If I move from A to B, so this will be an anti-clockwise direction. So the direction of A cross B will be given by this. Now, if I am supposed to calculate B cross A, then I have to move in clockwise direction. So this will be given by, as per right hand thumb rule or right hand corkscrew rule, this will be the direction of B cross A. Are these two vectors equal? No. Although their magnitude is equal, but they are pointing in the opposite direction. So we can say A cross B, it is not equal to B cross A, but I can write A cross B, it is equal to minus times B cross A. That is, cross product of two vectors is anti-commutative. So A cross B is not equal to B cross A, but A cross B is equal to minus times B cross A. That is, cross product of two vectors is anti-commutative. Right? Now, property second, if I have three vectors, A, मेरे पास तीन वेक्टर्स अगर हैं A, B और C, then this is A cross A, B plus C. If I want to find this way cross product, this will simply be equal to A cross B plus A cross C. That is, cross product is distributive over addition. That is, cross product distributes over addition. This is the distributive property of the cross product. Now, number third property of the cross product is, it is not associative. That is, if I have three vectors A, B and C, then A cross of B cross of C, it is not equal A cross of B cross of C. So cross product is not associative. Lekin agar mere paas char vectors hain, A, B, C or D, इनको मैं अगर ये ऑपरेशन करूं, दिस इज ए प्लस बी क्रॉस ऑफ, आई एम ऑपरेटिंग देम बाय दिस क्रॉस एंड दिस इज सी प्लस डी. इफ आई हैव दिस वेरी रिलेशन, देन दिस इज इक्वल ए क्रॉस ऑफ सी प्लस ए क्रॉस ऑफ डी प्लस बी क्रॉस ऑफ सी प्लस बी क्रॉस ऑफ डी. दिस रिलेशन होल्ड्स. नाउ one more property of the cross product is that cross product of a vector with itself. If I want to find A cross A, that is A cross A, cross product of a vector with itself. Suppose this is vector A, this is also vector A, and the angle between A and A is equal to zero. So as per definition, this will be equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of A into sine zero. Since sine zero is zero, so cross product of a vector with itself always gives a zero vector. Now, if the two vectors are parallel, for example, मेरे पास दो vectors हैं, ये vector A है और ये vector B है. Suppose they are parallel to each other, तो angle क्या है इनके दरमियान? Again equal to zero degree. So if I have two parallel vectors or anti-parallel vectors, if the vectors are anti-parallel like this, suppose this is vector A, this is vector B, here angle will be equal to 180 degree. और आपको ये भी पता है, whether it is sin 0 or sin 180 degree, it is equal to 0. So, this is A cross B. If the two vectors are parallel or anti-parallel, this will be equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B, either sin 0, that is equal to 0, sin 180, that is equal to 0. 0 into something is equal to 0. So, two non-zero vectors are parallel or antiparallel only and only if their cross product is equal to zero. Now, let us try to find this very cross product for orthogonal unit vectors. Agar mere paas orthogonal unit vector system hai, like we have in Cartesian coordinate system in space, like we have this is for example x-axis, this is y-axis and this is z-axis, and you already know along x-axis we represent the unit vector by ik, along y-axis by jk and along z-axis by kk. Now let's try to find out first I cross I. So this will be I cross I, magnitude of I, magnitude of I, again angle between I and I it is equal to 0, so sine 0 is equal to 0, so this will be again equal to 0. So similarly we can say J cross J is also equal to 0 and K cross K is also equal to 0. That is, cross product of two like vectors is equal to 0. Now let's try to calculate I cross J. Now see, as per definition, this is equal to magnitude of I, magnitude of J into sine of the smaller angle. Here you can see they are orthogonal, mutually perpendicular unit vectors. So angle here is 90 degree. और आपको ये भी पता है as per the definition जो कि मैंने आपको पहले ही कहा है, cross product is a vector product, so it should give a vector quantity and the direction of J degree vector quantity is given by n k perpendicular to the plane of paper or plane of board as per right hand rule or corkscrew rule. Magnitude of I is 1, magnitude of J cap is 1, sine 90 is equal to 1, so 1 into 1 into 1, that is equal to 1. And here क्या बचा यहाँ पे n k. What is n k? Unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing I and J. आप diagram से देख सकते हो, simply k cap है. So this I cross J, it will be equal to k cap. और पहली ही property आपको याद है, this cross product is anti-commutative. अगर मैं J cross I निकालूंगा यहाँ, that will be simply equal to minus k cap. और ये I cross J है. अगर मैं आप J cross k निकालूंगा, this will be again magnitude of J, magnitude of K into sine 90, again unit vector nk. So this is 1, this is 1, this is also equal to 1. And the unit vector perpendicular to J and K, from diagram you can easily see, it is equal to ik. So you can interpret this J cross K, it is equal to ik. Or from the property aapko yaad hai, अगर मैं k cross j निकालना चाहूं तो that will be equal to minus ik. Similarly I can calculate this was I cross j, j cross k, और मैं अब k cross i calculate करूंगा यहां. K cross i again equal to magnitude of k, magnitude of i, sine 90 into unit vector nk. So this is k cross i, unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing K and I, this is simply equal to JK. So K cross I, it is equal to JK. और अगर मैं I cross K निकालना चाहूं, so that will be equal to minus JK. अगर आपको अब ये याद रखना है I cross J, J cross K और K cross I. Now see, if you move from I to J in anti-clockwise direction, this is anti-clockwise direction. See, I cross J equal to K, J cross K equal to I, or K cross I equal to J. And if you move in clockwise direction, I cross K, it will be equal to minus J, K cross J equal to minus I, and J cross I equal to minus K. So this is the cross product of orthogonal unit vectors. Now, one more property of the cross product of vectors, that is cross product of vectors does not change under reflection. What does this mean? This is A cross B, that is as per definition it is equal to AB sine theta into n cube. Now if I change the vector A to minus A, and if I change the vector B to minus B, then if I take the cross product of these two, that is minus A cross minus B, it will be again equal to A cross B. That is, cross product does not change under reflection operation. Right? Now, let's write the cross product of the vectors in terms of rectangular coordinates. That is, अगर मेरे पास ये वेक्टर ए है, इसको मैं अगर इन टर्म्स ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर कंपोनेंट्स लिखना चाहूं तो कैसे लिख सकते हैं? दिस इज ए एक्स आई प्लस ए वाई जी प्लस ए जेड के और दिस इज वेक्टर बी, दिस इज इक्वल टू बी एक्स आई प्लस बी वाई जी प्लस बी जेड के. नाउ इफ आई वांट टू कैलकुलेट ए क्रॉस बी, simply you can do it like this, ax bx I cross I. Now you already know I cross I is equal to 0, so I should write here this is ax by. Aur aapko ye bhi pata hai I cross j that is equal to kk. Now plus this is ax bz. Now what about this? Let me write here I, j and k. If it is I cross j, it is equal to k. Now here it is I cross K. Had it been K cross I, then it was equal to J. Now this is cyclic order basically. This is I, this is J, and this is K. So I can write here this is I cross K. That should be equal to minus JK. Okay. Now, plus this is AYBX. This is AYBX. This will be equal to J cross I. J cross I, one second equal to minus KK. So this is minus KK. J cross J, zero. Then J cross K. Let me write first. This is AYBZ. J cross K. Again in the cyclic order. So this is equal to IK. Plus, this is, okay, this was AX, AY, now AZ. So this is AZ into BX. AZ into BX, here it is K cross I. Now see, K cross I in the cyclic order, so it is equal to JK. Okay, then this is AZ BY, this is AZ BY. This is basically we are calculating the cross product in terms of its components. This is K cross J. K cross J, not in the cyclic order, so this will be equal to minus IK. And the last term K cross K, that is equal to 0. Now let me rearrange this. Now, see, it is I cap here, it is minus I cap here. Let me write it like this, I cap into. This is AYBZ minus AZBY plus JK. Okay, JK. AZBX minus AXBZ plus KK, we have AXBY, this is AXBY minus AYBX, this is cross product in terms of the rectangular components. Now, I can write it simply in determinant form. मैं दिखाऊंगा आपको इसको हम कैसे determinant form में लिख सकते हैं. अगर मेरे पास जो दो vectors हैं in terms of its components, you can simply find the cross product of these two vectors by writing them in determinant form. That is, we can write it determinant of, this is IK, JK, KK. Here you can write AX, BY, B, okay, AX, sorry, this is AY, this is AZ. Now, BX, BY, and BZ, and you know how to evaluate this determinant from R post, that is row post. Here, this is I cap it, AY BZ minus AZ BY minus J cap it. You can delete that very row as well as that very column. This is AX BZ minus AZ BX, then plus K cap it, AX BY minus BX AY. So this is how to evaluate the cross product of two vectors in terms of the determinant. Now let me write the last property, that is Lagrange's identity here. regarding dot product as well as the cross product of vectors. That is basically magnitude of A cross B square plus A dot B square, it is equal to A square B square. That is square of magnitude of A and square of magnitude of B. How? Now, आपको ये भी पता है, as per definition, magnitude of A cross B किसके बराबर होता है? This is magnitude of A. Magnitude of B into sin theta square. So, as per the definition, A dot B is equal to A AB cos theta. उसका भी square. So, this is A square, B square, sin square theta plus A square, B square, cos square theta. Now let me take A square, B square common. So this is sin square theta plus cos square theta. At trigonometric identity, its value is equal to 1. So here it is. This is A square, B square. This is what is called Lagrange's identity. और कभी कभी आपको क्वेश्चन आता है, फाइंड द यूनिट वेक्टर परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन कंटेनिंग ए एंड बी. बस मैं फार्मूला आपको बताऊंगा इसके लिए. यूनिट वेक्टर परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन कंटेनिंग ए एंड बी. आपको यह भी पता है, ये जो वेक्टर सी है, इट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन कंटेनिंग ए एंड बी. और अगर आपको यूनिट वेक्टर निकालना हो इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ सी, एज पर द डेफिनेशन आपको पता ही है कैसे हम यूनिट वेक्टर निकालते हैं. That is vector c divided by modulus of the vector. You can write plus minus here because this is also unit vector perpendicular upwards. This is also unit vector perpendicular to the plane of A and B, right now directed inwards. So I will write unit vector. Let me name that unit vector by nk. That is plus minus. What is vector c equal? A cross B divided by magnitude of A cross B. This will be the unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. So this was all about the cross product of the vectors. So let me revise the things which we discussed today. We started from the definition of the cross product, the direction of the nk by either right hand thumb rule or right hand corkscrew rule, the geometrical interpretation of this very cross product. Agar aapko yaad hoga, that is simply equal to the area of parallelogram or twice the area of the triangle, and few properties like it is not commutative, it is not associative, but it is distributive or addition. Then for like vectors, unlike vectors, for parallel vectors, and if for perpendicular vector sin 90 is equal to 1, that is A cross B will be equal to simply AB. Then cross product in terms of the rectangular Cartesian coordinates, Lagrange's identity. So this was all for today's lecture. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll be meeting in the next lecture. Till then, khuda hafiz.